Welcome to this short video looking at copy tree in SOLIDWORKS PDM Standard. Copy tree enables entire designs to be copied and file names changed. It allows the updating of metadata to happen automatically whilst also having the ability to find and replace parts of folder or file names. And finally, we can also exclude library components when using the copy tree function. If we take a look in our local vault view, I can browse to the design that we want to copy. Select the design and use the copy tree command. I could use pack and go inside of SOLIDWORKS, but we then potentially duplicate files or we have to manually deselect all of the components we don't want to copy, typically fasteners or standard library components. Within the administration tool, we're able to set up on a per user or group basis the ability to exclude certain folders of data from copy tree. So any files located in these folders are not copied. As you can see here, the administrator has excluded this component automatically so we don't duplicate these files. So first of all, we have the destination path for each file and file name, or we could simply browse and specify the destination location for all copied files. Once we change the destination path, we can see the file paths update but the file names remain and therefore warnings appear. We don't allow duplicate file names in our vault, so we need to give the files new names. Under transform operations, we have the ability to apply a prefix to the file, or we can add a suffix, or we have the replace command where we can replace one file name with another. So here we're going to look to replace the component called lens with lens cover, so we can find and replace, and that will go ahead and change the target file name for us. Alternatively, we can add a suffix to all of these files. So I'm just going to give these files a suffix, which is mark 1. We can see the locking pin has been excluded from this list. We have a number of options that we can use when performing copy tree. So we can include simulation results, name drawings after their models, but also preserve relative paths so any files stored in subfolders, this folder structure will be maintained on the copy data set. And then finally, we can check these files in automatically and assign a comment to these and then copy the design. Once the design is copied, we can now browse to the copy design and we can see in the contains list all of the files that have been copied. However, the locking pin is still referencing the standard library folder as this was excluded within the administration tool when using the copy tree command. If we take a look at the folder card, we can see that the project information has been updated based on the folder the files have been copied into. So we can have metadata being pulled automatically through to the copied files. We can also see the file names on the file cards have been updated also. Within the administration tool, we can set some options regarding properties when using copy tree. So we can decide what metadata we want to clear, so we're not copying existing properties from a file, but we can also assign default values to the files automatically, so that when the data is copied, certain properties are cleared and certain properties have a set value assigned to them.